if you are just joining us, you can see the coffin bearing Her Late Majesty Queen Elizabeth is being carried from Holyrood House in a hearse to St Giles Cathedral, where a service of thanksgiving for her life will take place. It is going extremely slowly, walking pace. Her four children are behind the hearse, walking together. They've come out of Holyrood House, the Palace of Holyrood, the Queen's seat in Scotland, of course, now the King's seat in Scotland. She has left Holyrood for the last time, having arrived earlier this summer. Still with William Cubitt here, expert on all things military. What are we looking at here? It's a real feast of beautiful uniforms and ceremonial.
Yes, indeed. So clearly the hearse flanked by the bearer party of the Royal Regiment of Scotland and the escort party of the Royal Company of Archers. And behind that is the King and the Royal Family. The King is wearing the uniform of a Field Marshal, carrying the Field Marshal's baton that was presented to him in 2012 by his mother, the Queen. The Duke of York is in mourning coat, but with the medals from his own military service in the Royal Navy.
And Mary, we were told by the palace this morning that the Duke of York would not be wearing uniform on this occasion as he is no longer a working member of the royal family. But you'll note that the Princess Royal and the Earl of Wessex and Forfar are in uniform.
And in the car behind is the Queen Consort, and she's accompanied by the Countess of Wessex, who is also the Countess of Forfar when north of the border, wife, of course, of Prince Edward, the Earl of Wessex. And if you have sharp ears, you may hear every now and again the sound of a gun, and that is the minute gun. It's going to be happening every minute from Edinburgh Castle.
Fired by 105 Regiment Royal Artillery from the ramparts of Edinburgh Castle, which is at the top end of the Royal Mile, so they're moving towards that.
And the crowds, as far as I can see, absolutely silent.
Queen!
And if you're just joining us, we are keeping our cameras on the procession, taking the Queen's coffin to St Giles Cathedral, currently going along Canongate. It's about halfway along the route. Actually left a few minutes later than expected. And then moved from Canongate to the High Street. And it is a ceremonial pace that the hearse is moving at, because it is accompanied by the Queen's four children on foot and giving the people of Edinburgh and further afield in Scotland, no doubt, time to say their farewells to Queen Elizabeth II. And when they arrive at St Giles Cathedral, a coffin will be carried in to the west door. Let's just listen to what's happening. Joining us live from Edinburgh, the sound of a gun just going off, the minute gun, which are happening every minute along this procession. The service of thanksgiving for the Queen's life was due to start precisely at 3. We think they were a little late leaving the Palace of Holyrood, maybe about 5 minutes late. They will arrive there, we think, in the next arrive at St. Giles Cathedral, we think, in the next 5 or 6 minutes. But there is the opportunity for the crowds to drink in the solemnity of the moment. The Queen's coffin being borne from Holyrood House to St. Giles Cathedral. Bearer party, escort party alongside. Behind the hearse, the Queen's 4 children. And if you can just see, those with very sharp eyes might be able to see a chap with a checkered headband. Now, he is the garrison sergeant major for Edinburgh, the Scots Guards, and it is he who is responsible for all the ceremonial that is happening today. It's a huge day for him. and we can see St Giles Cathedral in the foreground. Bill, what can we expect to see here?
Well, as they approach St Giles Cathedral, they will go past the north door, which is the door on the Royal Mile, and we may see the hereditary keeper of Holyrood House peeling off and going in through the north door. This is the Duke of Hamilton, and he will be given the crown of Scotland, and he will be placing that on the coffin when the coffin is inside the cathedral. And as the hearse moves into West Parliament Square, which is alongside the west door, the Guard of Honour of the Royal Company of Archers will give a royal salute as the sign of respect for the arrival of the coffin and indeed the King.
And then the coffin will enter St Giles Cathedral through the west door, is that correct? And what is the significance of that, Chris?
Well, Mary, I was just listening to Bill talking about the Crown of Scotland. It actually was brought to St Giles Cathedral this morning, and special arrangements were made between Historic Environment Scotland to guard the crown and the police, and it was secured in the cathedral and watched over. And shortly, when the Queen's coffin arrives, the Crown of Scotland will be placed on top. We also know that the flowers on top of the coffin, which is still draped in the Royal Standard of Scotland as it was yesterday on that journey from Balmoral, a different wreath of flowers today, white spray roses, white freesias, white button chrysanthemums, dried heather from the Balmoral estates, thistle as well, of course, for Scotland, along with rosemary and hebe. And that has been placed on top already, but when it gets to the cathedral, significantly, the Crown of Scotland for the late Queen will be placed on top.
Thank you.
and the coffin has arrived in West Parliament Square, Bill.
And the guard of honour of the Royal Company of Archers in front of the West Door at the Royal Salute for the arrival of Queen Elizabeth's coffin.
The
garrison sergeant major there behind the hearse, ready to orchestrate this very delicate manoeuvre for the bearer party. I think we will see cap orderlies come forward to take the headdress of the bearer party, as they're obviously about to go into the cathedral. And then there will be the tricky manoeuvre of taking the coffin from the hearse and then up the steps and into the cathedral itself for the service.
Bill, would this have been something that they would have rehearsed
in
previous years?
They would have
just
rehearsed
in
it
case.
This time, yes.
Yes,
yes, of course. Yeah.
Hugely important to get it right, of course. Very complex. And Edinburgh still bathed in the most glorious sunshine. Bill Cubitt, as you so rightly said, the cap orderlies have taken the headdresses of the bearer party and they're now ready to receive the coffin of Her Late Majesty Queen Elizabeth. And in the car behind, the Queen Consort, who will be emerging. Chris, once the coffin has been taken out.
Yes, the Queen is about to enter the West Door with other members of the royal family and awaits the bearer party to remove the coffin from the hearse.